turn to the only lady in the panel. I'm really delighted to have you, madam. Why don't you address some of the questions I raised? I'm sure you all know her, but I think she's Bornali Bhandari, Senior Fellow with the National Council of Applied Economic Research.
Good afternoon, and thank you for inviting me to the SKOCH Foundation. When Dr. Kumar posed the question, East or West, and I reminded myself of the autograph we used to write, East or West, India is the best. Unfortunately, that's no longer true, because if you look at the data and what Dr. Kumar said, I just want to add that with number, re-emphasize with numbers. Our exports, imports of goods and services growth rate has fallen to 7.4 and 7.6%, or around 7.5% from the previous decade of 14%. That's a halving of our growth rates. Not only that, the interesting thing that when you analyze just numbers, not very casually, not even fancy econometrics, the shares of growth rates, shares of exports and imports have actually gone up to above 20%. This is just based on the GDP numbers. The question that then comes to us that we pose ourselves is India hitting its trade potential? If we are hitting our trade potential and we cannot go beyond that, essentially when you're reaching your potential, you grow at a slower rate. The question then boils down to the topic of the day, how do we improve our competitiveness? The trade and technology are the answers that traditionally that we have known. But now we are actually asking, should we improve trade or should we improve competitiveness? It's a chicken and egg scenario, which comes first. It's a no-brainer that the trade has to, we have to open, it's not a choice. The question is then, but there are going to be losers or people who do not gain from trade or are not prepared for openness. So I think the interesting thing again, which I want to add is that we have two mechanisms that we have developed over the last 10 years significantly, the direct benefit transfers mechanism. I'm not saying it's a work in progress, but it's still a lot of work has been done. Sophisticated mechanisms are being developed over time. And the skilling model has had its shares of pitfalls, but it has grown to be sophisticated. Both central and state governments are working on both these mechanisms, which could be used to actually address these problems. But the second thing that I want to add is technology. And here I also just have some numbers, and I can see they say they are fairly unique. NCR actually conducts a business expectation survey every quarter, and we assess business sentiments. But along with that, we actually look at, sometimes we experiment with asking about business e-readiness, which is essentially looking at the adoption of ICT, information communication and technology. And what we find is that the micro firms, the firms with annual turnover of less than 1 crore, are actually still quite behind their larger size firms. Only about, even though they have adopted ICT in finance and accounting, in the other mechanisms, they're still lagging behind. So I think the third key recommendation sort of is that we need to work on a dedicated basis with micro and small and medium enterprises and work with them so that they can adopt ICT in their production and make them more export oriented. I think smart and export oriented SMEs might be one of the key answers we're looking for. Thank you.